اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى اله سيدنا مولانا محمد مبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. فیضان مدینہ کے زیر اہتمام آج آئرلینڈ کی اس کیپٹل میں ڈبلن کی سرزمین پر ان دس بیوٹیفل پلیس وی آل ہیو گیدرڈ to contribute and to understand a very important topic of finality of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you, the management and all those who worked hard to make it possible today to be here in this place. And I've been informed that there were some elements who tried to stop this program, and the interesting thing for me, and I was surprised that when they were asked that whether do you have a problem with the speaker, you have some reservation regarding the speaker and the people, those who are participating in this beautiful program. And they said, no, we don't have any issue, specific issue with the speakers. And we don't have any problem with the speakers. Our concern is the topic of the program. And what was the topic of the program and what is the topic? The finality of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Khatm-e-Nabuwat, the topic which is the essence of our Iman and the essence of our faith and the base of our faith, the finality and the Khatm-e-Nabuwat of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the surprising thing is, those who have a problem with this topic, they claim that they are Muslim. Where in your mind there are some basics of Islam and some furu'at. As far as the basic of Islam concerned, and understand this very importantly, that these people will be trying to sow the seed of doubt in your mind and confuse you even afterwards. If they are active so much now, so I think they will try their best to confuse you afterwards. There are some basics of Islam. And Muslim Ummah from east to west, all over the world, you will never see the Muslim Ummah with all their differences divided on the basic of Islam. I can give you example to understand. Offering Salat. Salat is obligatory and farz upon us. You will never find any sect in Islam or any group in Islam with all their differences, with all their different division, you will never find any group in the history of Islam with the claim that offering prayer is not obligatory, there is no need of salat. This is the basic of Islam, the fundamental part of Islam in Amal. You will never find any group denying the importance of salat or the farida of salat at all. Yes, there are some furu'at. They all believe on the obligatory of salat. Salat is a fariza. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Is a zahir nas. Many verses of Quran, very clearly a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indicating this salat. Now, how to perform salat? You will see some, even in the frame of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, like Imam Azam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, how to fold your hands, where to fold your hands. Imam Shafi, bit higher, over belly button. Imam Malik, just only to raise your hands. So some scholar of Islam, even in Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, like Imam Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahumullah, they have a difference of opinion, and these difference of opinion based on the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These opinion is not from themselves. They have created and they have fabricated something based on the ahadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they have a different criteria how to take the hadith and make it their madhab and make their opinion that this way the salat have to be offered in action, where to raise your hand, here or here, or where to fold your hands, under belly button, over on your chest, or just leave it. And I remember one person in one meeting, he asked me that the you Muslim Ummah are so much divided that the action of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is performed daily minimum 5 times a day, in every single rakat of salat in fajr, minimum farz 2 rakat. In Zohar, minimum farz 4 rakat. In Asr, minimum farz 4 rakat. Altogether is 10. And Maghrib, minimum farz is 3 rakat, 13. And in Isha, 4 rakat, 4 units. 17 rakat. And if you include the 3 witr wajib, 20. Every single day, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is doing this action, and he was not doing this action secretly somewhere in a dark room separately. He was doing this action publicly as an imam of the ummah, as the prophet, and at the same time the leader, the spiritual leader, the political leader, the social leader of the ummah, where all the leadership is in the zaat of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So publicly he is offering daily 5-time prayer, minimum 20 units. And he did this action for years after years. And you Muslim are still not united where to fold your hands and where to raise your hand. So what kind of ummah you are? For the action which is every single day done by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The action which is every single day practiced by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The salat which is regularly, publicly offered by and performed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you are not united on this, the most important fariza and the most common and regular action of the Prophet, how you will be united on other thing? So this is a great and very big sign of division between Ummah. And I told him, whatever you regard is a great sign of division of Ummah, I regard the same as the great sign of the unity and connection with Prophet Muhammad of the Ummah. And he said, how come this division and these different action become connection to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I say, yes, you don't know how the Ummah is attached with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How the Ummah love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I say, you might have been with someone for 20 years, for 30 years, observing his facial expression, observing his actions, his figures. But after 20 years, if you ask anyone, can you in detail explain the expression of the person you have been with him for 20 years? I don't believe even the son can explain all regarding his father. The father can is regarding son, the worker with the boss. They will give you some clue, but they can't explain it in a detail. I said, this is the love of the Ummah and the Sahaba with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the hair of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam start getting white and gray, and from which area and how many, even some Sahaba mentioning the numbers, the love of the Prophet with the Sahaba, every single action recorded by Sahaba, every single expression of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recorded by Sahaba, how he was sleeping, how he was walking, how he was talking, how he was dealing with others, how he was offering salat, how he was traveling to Mecca, from Mecca to Medina, how he was welcoming visitors, day and night, every single action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is recorded, observed by the Sahaba. And because of this connection and love and attachment of Sahaba with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, more or less 500,000 people history has been recorded. More or less 500,000 people, their history has been recorded. And the reason of this record, their birth, their nations, their period, their time, their authenticity, their character, their behavior, their akhlaq, their morality, the reason they all were somehow connected with the narrating the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because of this connection, the Muslims have recorded more or less 500,000 people and their history, their character, their akhlaq, their knowledge, their period, their time. They were related to my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved their history. The biggest fun in Islam is Asma'ur Rijal. In no other religion you will find this kind of documents regarding the public in such a vast number of people, their place of birth, when they were born, where they have studied, who was their teacher, what were their own character and behavior. And all these are important to us. They are somehow related in the chain of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when we say our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though he is resting in Gumbad-e-Khadra, in Madinatul Munawwara, but as a seerah, as his character, as his behavior, as his every single moment of his life, he is a living Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we as a ummah know every single action of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I say, this is showing the attachment of the Sahaba. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes they raise his hand, sometimes till here, sometimes till here, sometimes folding underbelly button, sometimes on chest, sometimes leaving. Every single action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recorded. And I said to him, whatever you regarded disunity of the Ummah, I regarded the connection of the Ummah with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That many leaders, only their name has left in the history, or there are some very special actions, but out of all the world leaders, right from Adam till now until Day of Judgment, the only leader will be Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whose every single action is preserved by the Sahaba ikram ridwanullahi ta'ala alaihim ajma'in. And this is the Mashiyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through different people in different way, preserve every single action of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whether raising a hand here or raising hand here or folding up and down. All these action has been preserved by the Ummah right from the Sahaba till now, and it will be preserved till Day of Judgment, inshallah. Why I'm doing this, I have a different evidence. The one who is not folding, he have his own evidence. I can say why I'm not doing this one and this one. This is another scholarly debate. And we have our own the line. They all, these ulama and these scholars and these aima, when they were setting example for us, they didn't deny that these are not the action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They say, yeah, these all are the action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But I prefer this because this is the last action of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have a criteria that whatever is the last action of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is for guidance, it is for continuous sunnah. Though all other the action of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but I follow this action, this was the last action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some have the other criteria, some have other criteria. But we come to conclusion, every single action is the action of my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Koi ek bhi action aisa mere imam ne mujhe nahi bataya ki jo ho to Rasulullah ki hadith aur Mustafa ka action ho. Maine kaha ki if you want to come to the division, tell me any single action which is not done by the Prophet Muhammad and anyone is following him. This is showing the connectivity of the Ummah with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah preserved the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah preserved all the action of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this Ummah preserved every single word of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and every single action of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why we proudly say, hum us zinda nabi ko mante hai, jo apne jism ke saath to apni kabre anwar mein aaram kar raha hai, magar seerat ke saath, apni sunnaton ke saath, apne afaal ke saath, apne aqwal ke saath, apne amal ke saath, kal bhi wo maashre mein zinda tha, aaj bhi zinda hai, subah qiyamah tak koi mere Muhammad ki seerat ko nahi mita sakega, mere Muhammad ki seerat ko nahi mita sakega, na mere aqa ki sunnaton ko mita sakega sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, whatever is basic, jo bunyadi cheez hai, us par ummat ka hamesha ittefaq raha hai. Jo furui masail hai, furui masail, usme first century mein bhi ikhtilaf raha hai, second century mein bhi ikhtilaf raha hai, third century mein bhi ikhtilaf raha hai, fourth century mein bhi ikhtilaf raha hai, throughout the history ulama ka, lekin us ikhtilaf ki bunyad خود ذات محمد مصطفیٰ کی سیرت کا کرائٹیریا ہے. کسی نے اپنے نفس اپنی خواہشات اور اپنی ذات کو سامنے رکھ کر فکر نہیں دی. جس نے بھی دی ہے سیرت محمد مصطفیٰ اور سنت محمد مصطفیٰ سے روشنی دی ہے. یہ اللہ کی مرضی تھی کہ میرے رسول کی ہر ادا محفوظ ہو. میرے نبی نے کبھی کھڑے ہو کر پانی پیا, میرے نبی نے بیٹھ کر پانی پیا. جب زمزم پیتے ہو تو کھڑے ہو کر پینے کی رسول کی ادا یاد آتی ہے, جب عام پانی پیتے ہو تو بیٹھ کر رسول کی ادا یاد آتی ہے. میرے یہ ایک بڑا واسط سبجیکٹ ہے کہ جس کو لوگ اختلاف سمجھتے ہیں, میں اس کو علماء اختلاف علماء امتی رحمتن
جو کسی فریم کے اندر ہو کسی ضابطے کے اندر ہو کسی قائدے کے اندر ہو امت کے اس اختلاف کو ہم رحمت کہتے ہیں اور میں ہم نے کئی مرتبہ اس پر علماء نے کتابوں کی کتابیں لکھی ہیں کہ علماء کے اس اختلاف سے امت کو نقصان نہیں امت کو فائدہ ہوا ہے سمندری جانوروں میں کون سے جانور حلال ہیں کون سے حرام ہیں امام ابو حنیفہ کا اپینین امام الشافعی سے ڈیفرنٹ ہے آپ خدا کی شان دیکھیں کہ جتنے امام ابو حنیفہ کو فالو کرنے والے ہیں وہ سمندری علاقوں سے دور رہتے ہیں ان کا زیادہ غذا اناج ہے سمندری سی فوڈ ان کی زیادہ غذا نہیں ہے اور موسٹلی جو فالوور آف امام الشافعی ہیں ان کی سی فوڈ غذا ہے اب یہ تقسیم خدا کی دیکھیں کہ امام ابو حنیفہ جن کے فالوور کا جو بیسک فوڈ ہے وہ سی فوڈ نہیں ہے بلکہ زیادہ اناج ہے وہ صرف سمندر کے خاص جانوروں کے بارے میں اپنی رائے دیتے ہیں جسے سمک کہتے ہیں امام الشافعی کی حلت کا پوائنٹ آف ویو اس سے وائڈر ہے جن کا سی فوڈ سب سے بیسک غذا ہے اور سمندر کے کنارے رہتے ہیں وہ امام شافعی کے فالوور ہیں جو امام شافعی کے فالوور ہیں جن کا سی فوڈ بنیادی غذا ہے اللہ نے ان کی زندگی کو وہاں آسان بنا دیا جو ہم امام ابو حنیفہ کے فالوور ہیں ہم جن علاقوں میں رہتے ہیں خوراک کے بنیادی زندگی کے تقاضوں میں اللہ نے ہماری زندگی کو یہاں آسان بنا دی اگر یہ برعکس ہوتا تو ان کے ماننے والے مشکل میں ہوتے اور اگر ابو حنیفہ یہ اللہ تبارک و تعالیٰ نے علماء کے اس اختلاف کو جن کو فرمایا کہ اختلاف علماء امتی رحمت یہ اختلاف دس از اے مرسی آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ دیز ڈفرنس آف اپینین از اے بلیسنگ آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ اینڈ یو مائٹ بی تھنکنگ ان دا ٹاپک آف ختم النبوہ وائی آئی اسٹارٹڈ دس کوسچن اینڈ وائی آئی اسٹارٹڈ دس ویری امپورٹنٹ اینڈ سینسیٹیو ٹاپک دا ریزن آف دس وین ایور دیز پیپل those who have against the concept of the Khatm al-Nubuwah and those who are denying the finality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first and the beginning point to confuse you, they say, why you are declaring us kafir and why you are not accepting us Muslim? The people have differences already. Go to the mosque. Some people are raising hand here. Some are raising hand here. Some are not folding at all. Some are folding at all. One is called Hanafi. One is called Shafi'i. One is called Maliki, one is called Hanbali. All these people are still Muslim and they are working side to side, living side to side. If they with all their differences still remain in the frame of Islam, so why we are not accepted? You understand the fitna of these people? From where they start confusing your mind, from where they start polluting your mind, from where they start to put seed, sow the seed of doubt in your mind. They said this difference is always in the Ummah. The Ummah is already divided. There are differences of opinion. The people are doing different action. Go for their Salat. Go for their fasting. Go for the concept of Zakat. Go for the Halal and Haram. As I give you the example of seafood. They have a difference of opinion. If Imam Abu Hanifa have a difference of opinion, then Imam al-Shafi. Imam al-Shafi has a difference of opinion. Then Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal have a difference of opinion than Imam Malik. None of them declared each other kafir. None of them declared each other kafir. And still they are living in the frame of Islam. So why we are declared non-Muslim? And we are not accepted as a Muslim? So the simple answer to all these which they are polluting your mind. This is the ikhtilaf of furu'i masail, which is based on the frame of Islam. These things accepted throughout the Islamic history all the time. And the Muslim Ummah have difference of opinion based on their scholar, the great scholar with all their differences. And this is true with all their differences. Abu Hanifa, with all his hundreds and hundreds, in a thousand masail difference with Imam al-Shafi, he never declared Imam al-Shafi kafir. Imam al-Shafi, with all difference of opinion, he never declared Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal kafir. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, with all difference of opinion, he never declared Imam Malik kafir. They still, with all their differences, they used to respect each other. They used to honor each other. They used to regard each other the great scholar of Islam, the servant of the deen of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the question again, this is different than the way you are thinking. None of them, those who have the different way of offering salat, None of them denying Salat is not obligatory. Tell me any single sect in Islam who says Salat is not obligatory. The reason, these are the furuat reflected from the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. As far as the basic, as far as the usul, as far as the bunyad, as far as the basic aqaid and amal, no man is in a position to deny the prayer itself is not obligatory and deny the action of prayer in Islam. If anyone deny this, this denial of prayer is different than how to perform the prayer. Denial of the prayer itself, isme zameen aasman ka fark hai ke namaz farz hai ya nahi is baat mein aur isme ke namaz ko kaise padha jaye. Namaz ki farziyat ye qati masail hai amal mein. Namaz ki farziyat ka inkar kufr hai isliye ke ye Quran ki ayaton ka inkar hai, Rasoolullah ki sunnaton ka inkar hai, احادیث صحیحہ کا انکار ہے, پوری اسلامک ہسٹری کے صحابہ کے عمل کا انکار ہے, رسول اللہ کی ساری زندگی کا انکار ہے, صحابہ کی ساری زندگی کا انکار ہے, تابعین کی ساری زندگی کا انکار ہے, right from the time of Prophet Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم till now, the اجماع of the ummah, the action of the ummah, the unity of the ummah, the عقیدہ of the ummah, the basic عمل of the ummah throughout the history. If anyone deny the farziyat of salat, he is challenging the life of the Prophet and Sahaba and Tabi'in throughout the history. This is different than how to perform it. The same, there are something which is known as a base of Islam. For example, I give you the example, another example, in Aqaid. If you read the Quran in detail, the concept of Tawheed and oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a unique concept in Islam of Tawheed. Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Tawheed fil Asma'i wa Sifat, Tawheed fil Ibadat, Tawheed fil Sifat is a very clear concept in Islam. And if you go to the Godhood and Lordhood of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the whole Muslim Ummah is united. You will never find anyone from east to west, any firqa, any sect, who say, no, you are still Muslim if you believe in two gods. Have you heard in all of your life? Have you heard all of your life any sect in Islam who say, still you are okay if you believe in two gods? These are the basic articles. To remain Muslim, there are some basic and fundamental things. Understand these things. And why I'm repeating again and again these words to my youngsters especially. This is the biggest fitna of Qadianiyya or Ahmadiyya or all those who are challenging the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They are confusing your mind and polluting your mind with these differences and not giving you the clear picture. Yes, there are differences, but there are on two levels. World difference in basic aqaid, in the basic fundamental of Islam. No sect in Islam is denying the basic fundamental article of Islam. The oneness of Allah, from east to west, you will never find any group who deny that and say there is two God and still remain Muslim. From east to west, you will never find any sect in Islam who believe that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not the messenger of Allah and still remain in the frame of Islam. يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. The first condition which put by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that article of faith, the base of your iman will never be iman regarded, will never be accepted in Islam, if you don't believe with the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you don't believe with the risala of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you don't believe Quran is a divine revelation. These are some basic fundamentals set by Islam throughout the history. And whatever meaning is given by the ulama, accepted from first century till now, right from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, till now, no one differed, no one deviated from this path. They know these are the fixed article. If I want to remain Muslim, I have to be fixed with this. And I'll give you very other simple example. If someone say to you, that I want to translate Quran based on dictionary. Yes? Because Quran is revealed in Arabic. In translation, for understanding, you have to go to dictionary. Okay? And then he opened the dictionary. And he said, Allah says, this example many times I give, but this is related to my topic of Khatm-e-Nabuwat. And he said, listen, Quran is revealed in Arabic. And the dictionary is the main source of any language to understand it. Yes? Yes. Okay, accepted. So then what? You know those people with the white cap, with the turban, with the jubba, and with your shalwar kameez, those people who are going to mosque and they are offering salat, they are okay? It is a one meaning of salat. But those who are going to the pub and dancing together, they are doing salat as well. And it is okay. And you'll be saying, from where you got this meaning, going to the pub and dancing and you are doing salat. And he said, come on, open the dictionary. And you open the dictionary, in Arabic dictionary, you will find the salat meaning prayer, the salat meaning, but one meaning of salat is tahriku salawain, dancing. Yes? So there is a meaning of dancing in dictionary. No one can deny it. Go any authentic dictionary you open, one meaning of salat is dancing. Is it right or not, Maulan? Tahriku salawai. Yeah? So now he said, because this is the meaning proven by Quran. So what salat you are doing is also good, getting close to Allah. And the salat which is in the midnight of weekend, I am doing in the city of Dublin, this is also me getting me close to Allah. It is accepted. Will you go with it or not? Why? The dictionary is saying this, so why? My question to you, why not accepting this bichara? He is saying something which is based on dictionary and Quran is revealed in Arabic, so what is the problem? And how you will challenge him? Yes? How you will challenge him? If someone said to you regarding any language that this, whatever you mean by it is fine, but one meaning is this and proven by the dictionary, so what? If I'm taking this meaning of this, so what's problem with you? You go to your meaning, I'm going to my understanding. What are you going to do with it? Here is the answer. The Deen Islam, the whole Quran and Sunnah, is not only based on the dictionary. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُزُوهُ وَمَا نَحَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. Allah says, don't just always open dictionaries and books. Whatever I reveal, I not only reveal the book, I send a personality with the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will be practicing in front of you. And this meaning which is explained, interpreted by this Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the meaning. And the Sahaba says to Rasulullah, now if someone asks me, what is the problem going to pug and dancing and according to dictionary is proven, and I say, no, you are wrong. And he say, why I'm wrong? The Arabic language is supporting me. Arabic dictionary is supporting me. Arabic meaning of salat is supporting me. I'm not saying you are doing wrong. One meaning you go with it, one meaning I will go with it. Ek matlab tum lekar chalo, ek matlab main lekar chalta hoon. تم مسجدوں میں خدا کو راضی کرو, میں پب میں ڈانس کر کے خدا کو راضی کرتا ہوں. تمہارا پرابلم کیا ہے مولانا؟ The Sahaba says to the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, یا رسول اللہ, اللہ says so many times اقیم الصلاة اقیم الصلاة اقیم الصلاة, so many times the commandment of salat by Allah سبحانہ وتعالی, but is not explained how to do salat. The demand which is repeated so many times in Quran, how we perform it, Ya Rasulallah? And what was the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, Sallu kama raaitumuni usalli. The commandment is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The guidance is in Quran. The every verse after verse after verse is telling you how to offer salat. But if you want to know how to do it, don't run to the dictionary always. Don't run to the other book. Don't run to any explanation. The one who is sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you complete example. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ اُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. The guidance, the ideal, the character, the set example for you will be the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sallu kamara aitumuni usalli. Offer prayer as I Muhammad offering prayer. So the Sahaba look at it, how he is performing salat. The Sahaba followed it. It means the dictionary might have a 50 meaning, but for me the salat meaning is the one which is explained to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and followed by the Sahaba centuries after centuries after centuries. Is that clear to you or not? So here you have to understand, if anyone come the Khatm-e-Nabuwat and he said this Khatm-e-Nabuwat, these ulamas misguiding you, there are meaning of Khatm-e-Nabuwat is this and this and this, open the dictionary, and you don't have the vast knowledge of Islam to challenge it. And these are the tricks which I'm telling you, they are confusing ordinary people, very ordinary people. One trick is this. They will open, I recited the verse from Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse number 40. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Please move forward, so leave the space for others. MashaAllah, I think the people, those who are waiting outside, rather than waiting outside, they can get in, please. So, and this is, I see, the barakah of the Khatm-e-Nabuwat, the way you are looking like the Jummah Ijtima. Who united you is the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I always say to my brothers, listen, keep your differences with you, but whatever is the unity, come to the unity, because now we have challenges as a ummah. We have a challenges as a ummah. That's why I started from the concept of there are challenges we have as a ummah. They are not asking my sect, they are not asking your sect, they are not asking my firqa, they are not asking your firqa. They're treating each and every one of us. If my daughter is going to school and your daughter is going to school and your daughter is going to school, the one who have a hatred against ummah, he will never ask which firqa you belong to, oh young lady. His sign of Islam is enough to be targeted because she belongs to Islam. And when you have a common elements in the society who are against you, common elements in the society, then you will only fight against these elements and evils in the society to join each other and to become united and fight and stand together as a ummah. Huwa sammakumul muslimin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the title of Muslimin, and we have left this title. Hunafa'a, the Deen-e Hanif, the title is given. Wa kadhalika ja'alnakum ummatan wasata. The Ummat-e Wasat title is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are not my title, these are not Maulvi sahab title, these are not Maulana Jameel sahab title. These are the title which is granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have left the title of Quran. We have left the title of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we are stick with our own title. And the result of this division of every single day, now the time came when we decided to have a conference on the name of the Khatm-e-Nabuwat, they stopped us and they polluted the mind of the people. And the topic of Khatm-e-Nabuwat has become for them is a division in the community. And I was shocked. Those who claim, how dare they claim Muslim, and for them the topic of Khatm-e-Nabuwat is a problematic topic. The Khatm-e-Nabuwat, the finality of the Prophet, is a topic of division, topic of fitna, topic of fasad, topic of fighting, topic of dividing the community. And if this is the topic of division, then the one day you will come and say that the Wahdaniyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also the topic of division. If the finality of Muhammad is the topic of division, then there is nothing in this universe who can unite the Muslim Ummah together. Agar Khatm-e-Nubuwat, Khuda na khasta, Allah na kare, in saazishiyon aur fasadiyon ki saazishon mein, Khatm-e-Nubuwat ka title aur Khatm-e-Nubuwat ka unwan, agar ye division ka unwan ban gaya, تو خدا کی قسم کائنات کا کوئی ٹاپک امت مسلمہ کو متحد نہیں کر سکے گا. اسی لیے تو اقبال نے کہا تھا یہ فاقہ کش جو موت سے ڈرتا نہیں ذرا روح محمد اس کے بدن سے نکال دو روح محمد اس کے بدن سے نکال دو فکر عرب کو دے کے فرنگی تخیلات اسلام کو حجاز و یمن سے نکال دو فرما اسلام کو اگر مومن کے دل سے نکالنا ہے تو اس کے نکالنے کا سب سے کارگر طریقہ ہے اس کے دل سے محبت مصطفیٰ نکال دو اس کے دل سے احترام مصطفیٰ نکال دو اس کے دل سے عقیدت و تعلق مصطفیٰ نکال دو جتنا امت کا رشتہ محمد سے کمزور ہوگا اتنا ان کا رشتہ کائنات سے کمزور ہوگا اور جتنا یہ محمد سے جڑے رہیں گے اتنا یہ امت بن کر اکٹھے رہیں گے صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. میں نے کبھی سوچا بھی نہیں تھا, میں خدا کی قسم, I tell you always, my mostly topic, if you go on YouTube and all the time, I always go for the unity of the ummah and the topic which is related to our day-to-day life. Mostly my topic in my durus is related to character, to akhlaq, to character building. And I thinking these are the issue we have to discuss it. We have family issues. We have children issues. We have our ID issues. We have so many problems in the society. And our target should be to polish ourselves and to make ourselves close to the, we are the ambassador of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this society. So most of the time I'm trying to polish our character, to polish our akhlaq. I don't have to shout who I am. I don't have to give a 3-hour speech to anyone who I am. My character should reflect, and the person should ask me who is this person who have such a beautiful character, and that someone respond that he is the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is always my target. And I'm thinking very positively, the more we get closer to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the character of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the more we enlight our heart with the love of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the better we will be in this society, and more of the problem will be automatically resolved. But I couldn't imagine in my life, and this is first time happened, and I was in a state of shock, that some people complained that the topic of the Khatm-e-Nubuwat is a problematic topic. And I say, how dare you can say next day to the people, I am a Muslim. Though we know who you are, but your own claim is itself telling you are the liar and you are lying. That the reason, the most common topic, as I give you the example of Islam, you are going for the Khatm-e-Nubuwat for dictionary. And I'm looking the Khatm-e-Nubuwat to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. You are understanding now after 14 or 15 centuries, what is the meaning of the Khatam-ul-Nabiyyin? And I'm looking directly who stayed day and night with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The one who spent every single life with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The one who was said, Hakaza nubasu yawm al-qiyamah. And one day Abu Bakr Siddiq in one side, and Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhuma in another side, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered in a gathering and the Sahaba was sitting. And the Sahaba look at it and they see the very beautiful manzar and the very beautiful scene that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in the middle, and on the right, in one hand, he is holding the hand of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and on the other, he is holding the hand of Umar bin Khattab. And when the Sahaba look at this beautiful manzar, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled and he said, and he knew the Sahaba are very happy with this, and he said, Hakadha nubasu yawm al-qiyamah. Do you think we are together here only in this Masjid-e-Nabawi? We are together here in the street of Medina? We are here in Battle of Badr and Uhud? No. On the day of judgment, when I appear in the Maidan-e-Akhirah, Hakadha nubasu yawm al-qiyamah, Allah will raise Muhammad in the same way. In my right will be Abu Bakr, in my left will be Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala. So who can know, who can understand better than Abu Bakr the meaning of Khatamun Nabiyyin? The one who was, when become Khalifa, the Musaylimah Kazab, the Musaylimah the liar, the one who in the last days of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent the message to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, And I tell you, you know, I'm correcting the Aqeedah and also time by time resolving the problem which they are creating as a fitna in your minds. The Musaylima Kazab, the liar, with whom fighting only, according to some historians, 700 the Hufad in the time of the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the time of Bakr Siddiq, they lost their lives. How many? 700 only Hufaz. Go to the Battle of Yamama in the detail. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. I'm coming to the time of the Prophet. This Musaylima, he sent the letter to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In what he said, Min Musaylima Rasulillah ila Muhammadin Rasulillah. He was accepting the prophethood of Muhammad. He was accepting, look at the documents, when he was sending to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the final letter before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam departing from this world. The letter was Min Musaylima Muhammadin ila Musaylima Rasulillah ila Muhammadin Rasulillah. He was saying that this is the letter from the Musaylima, the Prophet of God, to the Muhammad, the Prophet of God. And what is it? The brief message of this letter. And he said, you are the Prophet of God and I am the Prophet of God. So I'm not denying the prophethood of Muhammad. You know the people, those who are deceiving you, we are not denying the prophethood of Muhammad. The Musaylima, the Kazab, the liar, he was not denying the prophethood of Muhammad. He mentioned in his letter that, and he attested the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, Min Musaylima Muhammad Rasulillah ila Muhammadin Rasulillah, from the Musaylima prophet to the Muhammad prophet of Allah. As you are prophet, I am the prophet. So, O Muhammad, divide the world. Half is for you, half is for me. You know, he was very wise. Divide the world, half is for you and half is for me. But he said, but your Quraysh tribe is exceeding the limit. They are controlling the whole world. It is not acceptable. So if you come to compromise, you deal your side, I will deal my side. I will be prophet here, you will be prophet there. So his letter was Min Musaylima Rasulillah ila Muhammadin Rasulillah. The response of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Min Muhammadin Rasulillah ila Musaylima Kazab. The response from the Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, to the Musaylima, the great liar. And he said, Al-Ardu Lillah, this land is not belong to me, not belong to you, this belong to Allah. Yurithuha man yasha'u min ibadi. He granted to whom he want. He said, we are dividing the land now. You know, like the land grabber, this is your area, this is my area. And na'uzu billah, because he was a criminal minded. You know, like the criminal, they divided the area. Don't come to my area, I will sell drug here and you sell drug there. So this is your area and this is my. Have you seen this or not? So they divided, because he was a criminal minded. So his thinking was criminal. He thinking the best way to establish his prophethood with this criminal mentality. What he did? You stay in your own area, I won't touch you. Do whatever you want. And don't come to my area, don't touch me. I will do whatever I want with my people. So because he was the criminal minded, he said, stay in your side, don't come to my side. But the Prophet ﷺ replied, what al-ardu lillah? This is not related to me, not related to you. It is not the ownership. It is not grabbing the people. It is not taking advantage of the people. Al-ardu lillah. Zameen sab Allah ki hai, jise khuda chahta hai usse ata farma deta. So the Musaylima itself, against whom the Khalifa Akbar Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar started battlefield, more than 700 Sufah Sahaba martyred, 1,000 and 1,000 Sahaba martyred. If this is the criteria that he is accepting the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then claiming his own prophethood. If this was accepted, if this meaning was accepted, if there was any gunjaish in this meaning, the first person who will be surrendering to this meaning was Prophet Muhammad himself. And after him, the successor of Prophet Muhammad, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But no, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُزُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْ فَانْتَهُوهُ. The Khatm-e-Nabuwat meaning, he is in every meaning, he is the final prophet. No new prophet with the new title, with the new Sharia, with any meaning, whether Zilli, whether Buruzi, which they knew some very, very nonsense terminology they are using, and you might not heard of it, this is Zilli Nabi. And this is all his claim. When I start telling, if the time comes, inshallah, I will tell you how Mirza himself contradicted himself, that who is he? And I was telling to one of gathering, but you can believe on someone who know himself who is he, but he himself don't know who is he. He is contradicting himself. Sometimes he is saying he is Mujaddid, sometimes he is saying he is Muhaddith, sometimes he is saying he is Masih, sometimes Masih al-Ma'ud, sometimes he is Zilli Muhammad, sometimes Buruzi Muhammad, sometimes he is Misle Muhammad, sometimes Na'uzu Billah better than Muhammad. Na'uzu Billah, Na'uzu Billah. So ask him, who is he? He lost his own ID. And every single person who challenged the finality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam throughout the history of Islam, right from Musaylimah Kazzab to Aswad Ansi, from Atas Ansi to Tuleha, from Tuleha to Sajah, everyone throughout the history, look at it, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cleared in Abu Dawud Kitab al-Fitan, hadith number 4252. And he said, إِنَّهُ سَيَكُونُ فِي أُمَّتِي كَذَّابُونَ ثَلَاثُونَ كُلُّهُمْ يَزْعُمُ أَنَّهُ نَبِيٌّ. There will be 30 liars and claiming they are the prophet and claim the prophethood. أَنَا خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ لَا نَبِيَّ بَادِي. And he says, bear in your mind, I am the final prophet. After me, there is no prophethood. The door of the prophethood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has closed. No new prophet will come to come to guide it, because if you believe there is another prophet needed, then the verse of the Quran in Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 3, Allah says, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum, atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, raditu lakum al-Islam adina. Then, na'uzu billah, the Quran is lying. Allah says, I have completed your religion, I have completed my favor upon you, I have chosen Islam as a religion for you. So the chosen religion is Islam. The completion of favor is Muhammad. And takmilat in'am is Muhammad. So this is completed in every way, in any meaning. If you believe on any new, you are challenging the deen Islam. You are challenging the Muhammad. You are challenging the message of Muhammad. You are challenging the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are more than ulama says. This is not the time to start telling and explaining. More or less 100 verses in Quran who is mentioning the finality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if you go to the scholar, those who compiled books, apart from other evidence and apart from many other evidence directly from the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are more or less 200 ahadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioning the finality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And some of you, I just mentioned to you, one is from Imam Bukhari, hadith number 3232, is very the Imam Bukhari, which is mentioned 3535, very famous hadith, with a different wording by many narrators in many hadith books. This hadith is mentioned, but I am quoting from Bukhari, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Mathali. إن مثلي ومثل الأنبياء من قبلي كمثل رجل بنا بيتا فأحسنه وأجمله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, my example and my parable with other Prophet, میری مثال دوسرے نبیوں کے ساتھ, كمثل رجل, اس آدمی کی طرح, like a person who built a very beautiful house, فأحسنه وأجمله, and he made it very beautiful and very perfect and complete house, illa mawdi'a labinatin, but only one space of one brick, min zaviya, from one corner he just left only one brick. The whole beautiful castle is completed, everything is perfect, you can't point out a single place, but only in a one corner one brick is missing. Faja'ala an-nasu يَتُوفُونَ بِهِ وَيُعْجَبُونَ لَهُ
The people start visiting it and surprising and wondering, such a beautiful house, such a beautiful house. We never seen this beautiful house before.
But after visiting the whole house, they say, هَلَّا وُضِعَتْ هَذِهِ اللَّبِنَا
And they were saying,
هَلَّا وُضِعَتْ هَذِهِ اللَّبِنَا With all the completion, with all the beauty, why this one not brick is placed in this corner?
The Prophet ﷺ says, فَأَنَا اللَّبِنَا I am this final brick of this house of prophethood. فَأَنَا اللَّبِنَا وَأَنَا خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ And وَخُتِمَ بِيَ النَّبِيُّونَ And I am the final one on whom upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed the prophethood. أَنَا خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ This is the meaning of خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ
There is another hadith the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ الرِّسَالَةَ وَالنُّبُوَةَ قَدِنْ قَاتَعَتْ The Risala and Nubuwa both, you know there are two terms used, one is Nabi and one is Rasul. And the ulama defining in different way, but the most common definition of the Rasul and Nabi, the Nabi is the one who sent out for the guidance of the people, regardless of giving new book and new Sharia. But the Rasul, the one who is sent out for the guidance of people, with new Sharia and new book. The example of the Risala and Nubuwa, like Musa alayhi salam and Harun alayhi salam. Harun alayhi salam was Rasul, Musa alayhi salam was Rasul, and Harun alayhi salam is Nabi. Musa alayhi salam was given Sharia, Torah, he was given messengership, so he was Rasul. Harun alayhi salam was Nabi, he was not given separate book, he was not given separate Sharia, he was promoting the Sharia of the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. So Risala and Nubuwa, two terms used in Quran. So the Nubuwa is the lower level compared to Risala, where the new, the messengership or the new Sharia and the new book is not the condition for it. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned both of it. Inna risalata wan nubuwata qadin qata'at. The people might say the Risala is completed, Nubuwa is not completed. The Nubuwa is completed, Risala is not completed. They will pollute your mind. They will confuse you. They will start looking the dictionary and creating fitna in the ummah. Both status together mentioned by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Inna risalata wan nubuwata qadin qata'at." Risala and nubuwa has completed. Fala rasul ba'di wala nabiyya. There will be no rasul after me. There will be no prophet after me.
Nara takbir.
Na koi rasul mere baad hoga. اور نہ کوئی نبی میرے بعد ہوگا یہ اس کو انس بن مالک سے امام ترمذی نے روایت کی حدیث نمبر 200 different احادیث mentioning the finality of prophet محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم If I start quoting, we'll be sitting all night. But I'm just giving you the glimpse. Because you, when you go to your colleges, when you go to your uni, when you go to your work, as a doctor, as an engineer, as an IT specialist, these are the biggest fitna they polluted your mind. They say, oh, there's a difference of mind. So what does it mean? You have a difference of opinion. Your one mosque is doing this, the other mosque is doing this. Your one mosque is doing Eid in one day, the other mosque is doing Eid in another day. So what? If they remain Muslim, why not me? They are offering salat like this. If they... And you tell them these are the furu'at. There are some basic things where the ummah never divided upon it. I give you the example of the simple to remember forever. And this will be the great debate and a great tool with you. That the salat has a different meaning. Even the meaning of dancing. But if anyone today start dancing and say, oh, I come across with the meaning of dancing, so I'm doing this and I'm pleasing Allah. Is not accepted. Because you are challenging the throughout 1400 century of the Ummah, the day and night activity of the Ummah. You are challenging the authority of Sahaba, the authority of Tabi'in, the authority of Taba Tabi'in, the authority of the scholar. The whole Ummah from east to west, never anyone accepted this meaning of Salat. The only meaning of Salat which is established in the Ummah, the way performed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as this new meaning of dancing is not accepted, the Khatm al-Nubuwa have a specific meaning. No prophet, no messenger, no Nabi
whoever you bring and whoever you come is all fabricated and rubbish and nonsense. The Ummah has not accepted this meaning. Tell me in history, who from the Ummah accepted this meaning? If this was accepted, then why there was a fight between Ummah and these people who are fabricating things? One final thing I want to tell you regarding, rather than giving all these evidence, if you are interested, I will request the ulama, those who are living here. I'm not always here. Even I can come for this job to give you most evidence of the Quran and Sunnah of the finality of the Prophet. But I sure, inshallah, these ulama have the ability and capability to do it. But some very basic thing I want to educate you today. And one is this very common issue which I'm facing in different places. And learn this, bear in your mind, very importantly. I have a meeting in UK. And in this meeting, I still remember, I have mentioned in our letter that we have a multi-faith international conference and seminar. And we have invited people of different faiths, of Christian, Jews, Hindu, Sikh, and Buddhist. So we have a multi-faith conference, so we are inviting everyone. I've invited one official in UK. You know this group who today say the finality of the Prophet is not accepted, even this topic is problematic. Some of them somehow approached them. What was their discussion, I don't know. But what expression I get after their discussion, I can explain it to you. I got the phone from the same person and he said, I'm very pleased to see you, Mr. Rabbani, Sheikh Rabbani. You are holding such a beautiful conference. And in this conference, I'm more pleased to see you are inviting different people of faith. There is a Christian, there is a Jew, there is a Sikh, there is a Buddhist. And then he mentioned one name of this specific group and he said, have you invited him? I say, no, I haven't invited him. Look at the, how they are playing with the mind of the people. A proper Gora is talking to me on this topic now. I said, then what is the problem, Ms. Sheikh Rabbani? You are international conference organizing and different people of faith you are inviting. And you said in your own letter, I can't deny it because it was my letter with him. And I invited him based on the same. If the Christian can come, if the Jews can come, if the Hindu can come, if the Buddhist can come to your conference, why not this group? Why not their representative? What is the problem? I say, listen, I can explain to you very briefly. It is a very long topic, but I will not to make it short for you. I said, with all these groups, those who are living in a society very clearly as a Christian, as a Buddhist, as a Baha'i, they live with their own idea and they are very clear who they are. Yes? I say, our problem with these people are not living with their own idea. They are stealing our idea. And he said, what do you mean by this? I say, let me explain it to you. You know, you have a credit card in this country. Every credit card is specified that so-and-so is allowed to derive the money from the account. Yes? If anyone take my card and use it on his own and even take my PIN code and everything, use my card, use my PIN code, my everything and derive 400, 500, 600 pound, is it accepted? He said, no, what is called? It's called forgery. It's called fraud. I give him another example. I say, listen, because you are not a religious person, you are a very high up. So let's explain to you another way. I say, we have a Heathrow airport in London. You will see in Heathrow airport, the person who has a Bengali and have a Bengali passport, and he coming and he allowed by the authority to get into Britain. There was a Somali guy with the Somali passport. He was allowed to get into the Britain. And he completed his process. Somali completed, Bengali completed, Pakistani completed, Indian completed. They all came with their own ID, Indian, Bengali. And they are saying, I am Bengali, I am Indian, I am Indian. Suddenly what's happened? On the airport, one person came with a British passport. And he appeared to the immigration officer.
And they stopped him. And he said, you are not allowed to go to enter to Britain. And let's say I was observing from very far, and I said, this person doesn't make a sense. The Bengali with Bengali passport is allowed to enter to UK. The Somali with Somali ID allowed. The Pakistani with his own Pakistan. But this was a British passport and he's want to enter to London. So what's the problem in this? So the response will be the officer is this. Yes, the Bengali have a different nationality, but he came with the permission to enter. He had a visa. The Somali has a different nationality. He was not a British. They came with their own ID as a Bengali, as a Pakistani, as an Indian, as a so and so. This person came as a British, but the problem, he is the forgery. He took the picture of someone and used his own picture. Though he has a British passport, the Bengali, those who have permission are allowed. The Somali is allowed. The Pakistani is allowed. The Indian is allowed. But this with British passport is not allowed. He is a criminal. The reason is not the passport. The reason he is doing forgery using our passport and changing the picture of someone. I say our problem with these people is not their religion. Is our problem is their forgery. They are doing their own but using our name. I say as your credit card you want accepted. As your fake passport you want accepted. How we accept? I say if these people today announce, today, like the Christian clearly said, we are a Christian, this is our faith. We are not Muslim. The Hindu said, this is our faith, this is our basic. We are Hindu, we are not Muslim. We don't have any problem. We live in a society where people of different faith lives together. People of different colors live together. We don't believe on discrimination on base of race, face, color and religion. No. Is a civilized society. People of different faith, people of different religion, people of different ID, different race, different color. There is no place for discrimination in this country and anywhere. And Islam doesn't allow to discriminate anyone. He is Kala, he is Gora. He is this, he is that. I said there is a history of the Prophet. The Christian lives in Islamic world. The Jews live in Islamic world. And the Muslim living in non-Muslim world. Is it throughout the history, we have a very rich history. The problem, don't, they have polluted your mind with this thinking, we are intolerant people. We don't tolerate people. Yes, I say, we are the most tolerant people. And the evidence of my tolerance, I invited in my conference Christian. The evidence of my tolerance, I invited Hindu, I invited Sikh, I invited Baha'i, I invited everyone. The reason they are coming with their ID, they should come with their ID. We don't have any problem. These people are cheating our people. They don't believe on Islam and showing to the people we are Muslim. This forgery in a credit card is not acceptable. How you want to accept us in our religion? You don't accept it for the entry of your country. And you want us to accept it for the entry of our religion. I say, as for the entry of your country, with their ID, permission is accepted. Whoever you are allowed to come. I say the same way. If these people come, Jazakallah, if these people come with their ID, wallah, we don't have any problem with them. We will invite them. We will sit with them. We will discuss with them. But the forgery which is happening in our name, like our biggest problem of the community is this. You are allowed to show to the people whoever you are, but you can't say to anyone, I am the son of Allama Rabbani. You are not my son. You can't say to anyone, I am the, in a passport, in a visa, in a credit card, in a nationality. I said, this is called worldly forgery. Ye fraud, maine ka sari dunya mein tum mante nahi ho, aur hume kehte ho ki hum is fraud ko mazhab mein accept kar lein. अपने तारुफ से यहां कह दें कि हमारा इस्लाम से कोई ताल्लुक नहीं, हमारा बाप कादियानी है, हमारा दादा उसका दादा है, हमारा ये मजहब है, हमारा ये दीन, हमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. जहां करोड़ों खुदाओं को मानने वाले हिंदू एग्जिस्ट करते हैं, वहां ये भी एग्जिस्ट करते हैं. अब बात समझे कि नहीं समझे, ये बार बार हमें गुमराह किया जाता है और आप लोगों को कहा जाता है, यू आर वेरी अनटॉलरेट पीपल, वाई यू नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग, यू आर वेरी नैरो माइंडेड, यू आर वेरी रेसिस्ट. अच्छा, और यही टूल ये लोग आपके खिलाफ यूज करते हैं यहां पर सोसाइटी में. सी, वी आर वेरी पीस लविंग पीपल, वी आर वेरी गुड पीपल, दे आर नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग अवर एग्जिस्टेंस, राइट ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस. नो, यू आर लाइंग, यू आर डिसीविंग पीपल. इट इज नॉट द इश्यू ऑफ राइट ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस, इज नॉट द इश्यू ऑफ द राइट ऑफ लिविंग, द इश्यू ऑफ इज द आई डी. यू आर डूइंग फोर्जरी यूजिंग अवर आई डी.
The Christian is not using my ID. He proudly say, I'm a Christian. That's it. The Hindu proudly say, I'm a Hindu. That's it. The Sikh proudly say, I'm a Sikh. So my children are not mixing. They are not getting confusion in school, in college, and anywhere. They know I'm Muslim, he's Christian. With all difference of a faith, we have a respect for each other as a human being. We're living together, living side by side. I say, if you are intolerant society, we would not be working with Christian at all. We would not be working with Hindu at all. Those who believe in hundreds and thousand gods, we believe in one God. Still we are working. Go to the India. We are working together for centuries and centuries. We are living side by side. Here we are living side by side. Look at the history of Islam. The Prophet Muhammad and the companion live with Jews side by side. Live with Christians side by side. Don't mix up things. And don't be targeted by these people. This is the biggest hamla they are doing against you. As an untolerated people. As a narrow-minded people. As a racist people. Oh, these people are not accepting our existence. We accept everything for you. But we won't allow you to steal my ID. I say, as a country, you have a right. If anyone steals your ID on a passport, you put him in a prison. And requesting us to accept it to everyone. Jada ave. Main Muhammad nu nahi manda, Musliman na theek hai. Main Quran nu nahi manda, Musliman na theek hai. E Islam hai to koi high street hai. Jada dil aaye kare, muh utha ke turda phire. Koi zabta honda hai ki nahi honda. Aur main aapko bataun ki it is not the problem of Muslim. Even if you go to the Christian, evangelical or Jehovah Witness, they don't accept them as a Christian, and still they have some group, they have differences, but some group they totally don't accept them as a Christian. And when they come the debate, inshallah, I will tell you, these people are the forgery, doing forgery. And they are, with all their forgery, with all their fraud, still blaming us Muslims as intolerant people. We are not intolerant people. You are doing religiously criminal activities by using our ID and not believing on the basic fundamental of Islam. Either believe on it or either leave it. Either believe on it or either come with your own ID. Whatever ID you choose, I don't have a problem. Call yourself whatever you want. It is not my business to tell you what name you should be. Carry on. You can choose name for yourself. You can choose title for yourself. I'm not interfering in your business. But as I am not interfering in your business, don't interfere in my business. Don't steal my ID. Don't deceive my children, my family, in a school and in a college, telling them I'm a Muslim. And in reality, you don't believe what makes you Muslim. If anyone say I'm a Muslim and I don't believe in oneness of the God, he is not a Muslim. If anyone say I'm a Muslim but I don't believe on the finality of Prophet Muhammad, he is not a Muslim. This is undisputed matter. It is not like namaz, raise your hand here and there. Throughout the history from the Prophet till now, none of the Muslim scholar from East to West accepted that anyone who don't believe the messengership of Prophet and finality, he is a Muslim. That's this our case. Our case is very simple. But you people don't want to educate yourself. We are always living in a corner. Oh, please don't talk, we will be targeted. Don't talk, we will be discrimination come out. No, talk openly. But talk with reason, with sense. I'm talking with reason and sense openly, publicly telling you. We have a problem with them, but what problem? This is our problem, not the problem we don't accept them. We are racist, no. We don't have the right for them as existence, no. We don't have any problem with them. Our single problem, please don't steal our ID. As you don't allow anyone to steal your ID in your country, we don't allow anyone to steal our ID as a Muslim. As you have a right to protect your ID, I have a right as a Muslim to protect my ID with all means. This is the issue. Is it clear to you or not? कोई बात समझ में आई है या बिल्कुल नहीं आई? इसलिए अगर समझ आई है तो कल जाके उनके साथ इस कॉम्प्लेक्स से निकलो कि हम हमारे यहाँ बाद पढ़े लिखे लोग होते हैं. They don't understand the case. They say, listen, yaar, we have so many differences. So it doesn't matter. Let go with them. As we have other problems. Let this is no, this is different problem. मेरी बीवी का बच्चों का छोटा मोटा प्रॉब्लम घर में सारा दिन चलता है, पर कोई गैर बंदा आकर आपके बीवी और बच्चों का रिश्ता जोड़ने लग जाए तो वो प्रॉब्लम एक्सेप्टेबल नहीं है. वो कहेगा अल्लाह के बंदे, ये रिश्ते जोड़ना ये तेरा काम के नहीं, ये मेरी बीवी है, ये मेरे बच्चे हैं, You understand my point or not? छोटे मोटे प्रॉब्लम हर जगह चलते हैं, तो प्रॉब्लम का स्केल होता है, लेवल होता है ना। ये तो नहीं ना कि जिसका नाम प्रॉब्लम हो उसमें कोई स्केल ही ना हो। अगर प्रॉब्लम की ग्रेजुएशन ना होती, ग्रेड ना होते, तो फिर सजाओं का फर्क ना होता। एक काम है आपको सिर्फ कौशन दे देते हैं, एक ही आपको सिर्फ 6 महीने सजा दे देते हैं, एक ही आपको 6 साल सजा। एक जुर्म ऐसा जिसके लिए लाइफ इंप्रिजनमेंट, एक गद्दारी ऐसा जुर्म है कि बाद मुल्कों में तो सीधा लटका दो और नहीं तो सारी जिंदगी। तो अगर जुर्म में फर्क ना होता तो सजाओं में फर्क ना होता। हर प्रॉब्लम एक जैसा नहीं होता, ये प्रॉब्लम और है, जो तुम्हें हमारा प्रॉब्लम कहते हो वो और है। उस प्रॉब्लम में हम स्टिल मुस्लिम को एक्सेप्ट करते हैं और एग्जिस्ट करते हैं। ये हमारा कलेक्टिव प्रॉब्लम है, हमारी आईडी का और चोरी का प्रॉब्लम है। इस पे ना हमने कल कंप्रोमाइज किया था ना आज करेंगे। चाहिए मेरी मोटी मोटी बातें जो मैंने बहुत तफसील से नहीं की, ये बातें आपकी समझ में आई है कि नहीं आई? क्या अब भी हमें कंप्रोमाइज करना चाहिए? क्या अपनी आईडी पर कंप्रोमाइज करना चाहिए? क्या वो बंदा जो खुदा को एक ना माने, हम कोई खड़ा हो जाए कि मैं हूं तो मुस्लिम लेकिन खुदा को एक नहीं मानता, कंप्रोमाइज करना चाहिए? क्या के जो कहे कि मैं हूं तो मुस्लिम लेकिन कुरान को अल्लाह की बुक नहीं मानता, कंप्रोमाइज करना चाहिए? तो जैसे खुदा को एक ना मानना, कुरान को अल्लाह की किताब ना मानना, वो मुस्लिम नहीं हो सकता। जो मोहम्मद मुस्तफा की रिसालत और खत्म नबुवत का मुनकिर हो, वो सारी चीजें माने, वो कभी मुस्लिम नहीं हो सकता, नहीं हो सकता, नहीं हो सकता। ये हुजूर से लेकर सहाबा, सहाबा से लेकर आज, और आज से सुबह कयामत तक हमारा अकीदा। इसलिए वो मजलूम नहीं, मजलूम तो हम हैं। ये बड़ी जुल्म की बात है कि आईडी हमारी चुराई गई। ये तो ऐसे कि किसी ने कार्ड भी मेरा चोरी किया, भी मुझ पर करे। यहां पर मुझे वो लतीफा याद आया, वो कोई समवन इज स्टीलिंग इन द शॉप इज ए जोक समवन, जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड, टू एक्सप्लेन इट इन ए वेरी लाइट मूड, एंड ही ब्रोक द विंडो, ही ब्रोक द ग्लासेस एंड स्टार्ट स्टीलिंग द मोबाइल्स एंड थिंग्स, एंड द ओनर ऑफ द हाउस, यू नो, आउट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन एंड जस्ट टोटली शॉक्ड, ही सेड, "Brother, what are you doing? What are you doing?" And he said, "Are you blind? I'm stealing. Stay away from here." When he said in a shop, "What are you doing?" And he said, "Are you blind? What I'm doing? Stay away. I'm stealing. Don't say anything." So, chori bhi karta hai, sina zori bhi karta. Hamare yahan to ye musibat hai. Mazloom hum hain. Unhone aapko zalim bana diya hai. ID hamari chori hui, credit card hamara koi le gaya, shanakht hamari koi le gaya. और फिर भी कहते हैं कि जालिम आप लोग हैं। अगर हम तंग नजर होते, ये बात बार बार गोरों को समझाएं, कानों को समझाएं, अपनों को समझाएं, परायों को समझाएं, छोटों को समझाएं, बड़ों को समझाएं, अगर इस्लाम तंग नजर होता, इस क्रिश्चियन सोसाइटी में क्रिश्चियन के साथ सरवाइव ना करता होता, हिंदुओं के साथ ना करता, यहूदियों के साथ ना करता। थ्रू ऑफ द हिस्ट्री हमारा तो मोस्ट टॉलरेटेड रिलीजन है, हम हर एक के साथ गुजारा करते हैं। लेकिन जहां हर मजहब के साथ, हर नस्ल के साथ, हर रंग के साथ गुजारा करना जानते हैं, अपने अकीदे और अपनी शनाख्त को चोरी करने की किसी को इजाजत नहीं देंगे। इस्लाम हमें कहता है कि वो अपनी शनाख्त के साथ जिए, तुम अपनी शनाख्त के साथ जिए। ये तो हमारा राइट है कि नहीं? इसलिए इनके फितनों से बचे, इनकी शरारतों से बचे और इनकी साजिशों से बचे। आज मेरा दिल इंतहाई दुखी था और मैं चाहता था कि आप लोगों से शेयर करूं। मैं कह रहा, एक बात मैं आपको शाबाश देता हूं कि आप किसी नाम पर इकट्ठे ना हो तो ना हो, लेकिन मेरे आका मोहम्मद की खत्म नबूवत के नाम पर आज इकट्ठे हो गए। और मुझे यह खुशी है कि अब भी ईमान की वो चिंगारी बाकी है। हमारे कितने डिफरेंसेस हैं आपस में ये मुझे पता है, मुझे आप ना बताएं, आई नो बेटर देन एनीवन, जो सुबह शाम फेस करता हूं। लेकिन वही मैंने बात कहा कि शाह बतहा के नाम पर मिलकर खड़े होना, और लोहो भी तू कलम भी तू तेरा वजूद अल किताब, लोहो भी तू कलम भी तू तेरा वजूद अल किताब, कि मोहम्मद से वफा तूने तो हम तेरे हैं, ये जहां चीज है क्या लोहो कलम तेरे हैं। और इस मोहम्मद से जिसने वफा की है, खुदा ने उसे कभी मिटने नहीं दिया सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम। आज का इतना अजीम इज्तिमा और आपकी ये मोहब्बत देखकर मुझे यकीन कामिल हो चला है कि जो वो सोचते थे वो गलत था
और आप बेदार हैं और बेदार हैं, और आपने इसी बेदारी को आगे भी शो करना है। ये जो छोटी छोटी चीजें मैंने बताई हैं जिससे आपके बच्चों को कंफ्यूज करते हैं, इससे उनको निकालें। आप उनको कहें कि अगर आपने डिबेट करनी है तो हमारे उलमा इंशाल्लाह दिन रात डिबेट के लिए तैयार बैठे, किसी मैदान में आप हमें पीछे नहीं देखेंगे। ले आओ इनके जो सबसे बड़ा अपने आप को स्कॉलर डिबेटर समझता हो इस मसले पर। और लेकिन मैं हैरान हूं कि जिस मसले पर उम्मत का 1400 साल से इत्तेफाक रहा है, आज इनको जरूरत हो गई है कि हुजूर की खत्म नबूवत को भी उन्होंने चैलेंज कर दिया। और उससे बड़ी जरूरत यह है कि खुद मजलूम बन बैठे, आप लोगों को जालिम बनाया, जुल्म तो हमारे साथ हुआ है, हमारी शनाख्त छीन ली गई, हमारी आईडी चोरी कर ली गई, हमारी पहचान को इस्तेमाल करके दुनिया में हमारे कुरान को बदनाम किया जा रहा है, हमारी आईडी इस्तेमाल करके हमारे इस्लाम को बदनाम किया जा रहा है। इस्लाम की वो ताबीरात और तशरीहात कर रहे हैं जो न मेरे मुस्तफा ने की न मेरे खुदा ने की, और जो न दौरे सहाबा से लेकर आज तक किसी ने की। जुल्म तो हमारे साथ हुआ, लेकिन आज ये हालात की सितम जरीफी है कि वो जालिम मजलूम बनकर बैठ गए। लेकिन अब जो ये आज का वाकया हुआ, इससे मुझे पता चला कि उनको बड़ा हौसला है कि जब चाहे हम इन मुसलमानों के प्रोग्रामों को कैंसिल कर सकते हैं, उन्हें पता। लेकिन आज मैं उनको एक मैसेज देना चाहता हूं, तुम हमारी प्लेसेस को कैंसिल कर सकते हो, हमारे दिलों को कैंसिल नहीं कर सकते। तुमने जगह कैंसिल की ना, उसके लिए साजिश की, लेकिन जगह तो कैंसिल होने पर नई जगह मिल जाती है। ये जो दिल में मोहम्मद है, आबरूए मा जनाब मुस्तफास, दर दिले मुस्लिम मकाम मुस्तफास, जो मुस्लिम के दिल में मकाम मुस्तफा है, ये याद रखो, ये तुम्हें गलत फहमी है। इस मुसलमान के आपस में हजारों लाखों इख्तलाफ हों, लेकिन जब कभी खत्म नबुवत और नामूस मोहम्मद मुस्तफा की बात आए, फिर ये मुसलमान अपने सारे फर्क एक तरफ करके मुस्तफा की नबुवत का, खत्म नबुवत का सिपाही बनकर हर इफ्तराक और हर इंतशार और हर दीवार मिटाकर सीसा पलावी दीवार बनकर खड़ा हो जाता है। 1953 में पाकिस्तान में देखा कि हमारे मुख्तलिफ फिरकों के जमातों के उलमा थे, लेकिन जब खत्म नबुवत की बारी आई तो एक ही सफ में मुफ्ती महमूद भी खड़े हैं, उसी में काजी सनाउल्ला भी खड़े हैं, उसी में शाह अहमद नूरानी भी खड़े हैं, उसी में मौलाना अहमद मौलाना अब्दुस्सत्तार नियाजी भी खड़े हैं, उसी में बड़े बड़े पीर ऑफ गोल्डा भी खड़े हैं। ये सारे जो अपने अपने माहौल में अपने अपने काम में लगे थे, जब खत्म नबुवत की बारी आई तो फिर चश्मे फलक ने देखा कि वहां तो एक तरफ मक्का मुकरमा के राबता आलम इस्लामी में 1974 में अपने तमाम तर डिफरेंसेस के बावजूद जब खत्म नबुवत की बारी आई तो मशरिक से मगरिब तक तमाम मुसलमान एक होकर मुत्तफिक होकर कहा कि हमारे इख्तिलाफात और तफर्रुदात अपनी जगह, नामूस रिसालत के लिए कल भी एक थे, आज भी एक है। उसी अजमत को, उसी मोहब्बत को और उसी कैफियत को हमें आगे जारी रखना है। और इंशाल्लाह मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि आप लोग यहां पर, मेरी आपको एक मशवरा है, मेरा आपको एक इरादा है, एक मशवरा है। मुझे ख्याल है नमाज का वक्त हो चुका है, लेकिन एक चीज मैं जो इम्पोर्टेंट डिस्कस करना चाहता हूं, मेरा कि कम अज कम आप अपनी मस्जिदें चलाएं, आप अपने इदारे चलाएं, आप अपने ऑर्गेनाइजेशन चलाएं, आपको मुबारक हो, मेहनत करें, खूब मेहनत करें। लेकिन वो जो हमारा यूनिवर्सल टॉपिक है खत्म नबुवत, कम अज कम इन हालात को देख करके आज उनकी ये जरूरत हो गई है कि आपके प्रोग्रामों को चैलेंज करते हैं, आप अपनी एक मुश्तरक खत्म नबुवत कौंसिल बनाए, एक मिलकर यूनिटी का, उसमें अरब अजम इंडियन पाकिस्तानी बंगाली, लीव ऑल दीज डिफरेंसेस, टेक आउट ऑल दीज डिफरेंसेस इन बिटवीन, खत्म नबुवत के लिए एज वी शोड इन 1953 इन पाकिस्तान, इन द सेम वे यूनाइट योर सेल्फ, यूनाइट योर सेल्फ फॉर द खत्म नबुवत एंड हैव अ कॉमन ग्राउंड टू चैलेंज एंड टू फेस द चैलेंजेस ऑफ दिस। Otherwise, your own child will be questioning you in your home. And these questioning, the question which I am raising, they've already raised in the mind of their people, and especially very easily in the mind of their children. Because if someone become like you and hide his ID and as a forgery use your ID, it is very easy to convince your daughter to convince your son in a school, in college, in a business place, because he thinks he's like me, he's my Muslim brother. And becoming Muslim brother, they are looting your faith, they are looting your iman, and they are looting your aqidah. And the solution for this, you should have a united forum to face the challenges. We have to show to the authority what is our problem. We are the most tolerant people. We are not taking lying hands at all. We never supported this. We are law-abiding citizens in this country and everywhere. We never ever supported any extremism, any terrorism in the society, or any kind of violence in the society. Made clear to everyone, we don't believe in violence. But in one hand, we don't believe in violence. It is our clear message. In other hand, we will use all the possible means to stop these people using our ID. It's a very simple message you can give to everyone. Yes, we won't be violent. We won't use violence. We won't be involved in anything which is against the law of the country. That's it, clear. But we will use all possible means of this country and this land to fight for our rights. And this is the right the constitution of the country is giving us. Is this clear to everyone or not?
Yes.
This is a simple message I try to convey to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand this.